Well, kanina nga lang nagkaroon ng press conference ang four delegates ng Pilipinas para sa Miss Eco International, Miss Charm International, Miss Cosmo International, and para sa Miss Supranational Beauty Pageant. Alam naman natin na sila ay appointed, so only Ahtisa will be the first delegate na talagang confirmed na magko-compete this year para sa first edition ng Miss Cosmo International. Pero talagang bothered ako para sa press conference na to is yung look ni Alexi May Brooks. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Roderick Cruz Abala and today's video yun ang pag-usapan natin yung katatapos lang na press conference ng apat na delegates ng Pilipinas, Miss Eco International, Miss Charm, Miss Supranational, and Miss Cosmo International. Kitang-kita naman natin na Alexi May Brooks was ravishing. She looked different, but ang tanong, is she looking amazing? She has this beautiful, sexy, athletic body, but I think that na-overpower ng kanyang pagiging athletic yung overall look niya. Especially yung hair, I just really don't like the hair. Okay, she is trying to embrace her roots as African-American or whatsoever, but I think that hindi ganun kaganda, hindi ganun ka-pleasing. At first glance, I think that nagmukha siyang, I'm not gonna say a word, but hindi bagay sa kanya, hindi siya ganun ka-pleasing tingnan. I think that the team or her team should manage and experiment more how to make her look more feminine, more womanish, kind of thing. They need to play, or mas gusto ko pa yung styling niya before during the Miss Universe Philippines. Mas sexy, mas feminine. But this time, I don't really like the styling. Miss Charm naman, Cyril pa yung mo. Unang-unang napansin ko sa kanya is talagang very quiet niya. Very parang kabado pa rin siya, parang hindi pa rin siya ready. But she said that she is ready. Even Miss Charm 2024 will be tomorrow. If ever hindi niyo pa alam, Krishna Gravides was supposed to be the delegate get up to Philippines para sa Miss Charm International ngayon taon. But nag-back out nga siya dahil ngayon nandun siya sa Miss World Philippines, trying to clinch the Miss World Philippines title. So yes, so Cyril Payumo, she was asked and she said that she is ready, even the pageant will be next year or even tomorrow. But she doesn't look prepared. She doesn't look confident. Yun lang yung makikita ko, ay nakikita ko sa kanya. She really looked like very quiet. Hindi mo alam kung bobongga siya. Hindi mo alam kung talagang lalaban siya. I am very skeptical sa kanyang look, sa aura. I don't see that parang fighting spirit, but we never know, okay? Miss Supranational. Miss Supranational Philippines, Tara Valencia from Baguio, still the same. So medyo I think she need to learn how to speak short and sweet kesa yung papahabain niya paikot-ikot and then nauuwi siya sa parang confused na hindi niya mabigay ng tama yung mga sagot niya. She is beautiful. They're all looking beautiful, but there's some here and there na kailangan baguhin, kailangan improve. Ahtisa Manalo is the most confident, the most ready. I think that Miss Universe Philippines really did a good job for choosing her because she is the first delegate nga to compete internationally and she will compete this year para sa inaugural edition ng Miss Cosmo International. Ahtisa Manalo, saying that she is the most ready, she is the most prepared, it's not because she is my favorite during the Miss Universe Philippines. It's very obvious naman na talagang the way she speak, the way she look, she is ready. She is ready to compete internationally even tomorrow, even today. She is about to fly to Vietnam para sa promotional tour para i-promote nga yung Miss Cosmo International Beauty Pageant. And she look ravishing in blue, fresh, beautiful, styling on point. Of course, sinabi niya na syempre marami pa siyang kailangan malaman kung ano ba talaga yung Miss Cosmo International para alam daw niya kung ano yung pwede pa niya ibigay sa table. So this is it. This is a very very quick reaction video para dun sa press conference ng apat na delegates nga na to. Yun lang yung mga comment ko na sana is Miss Charm Philippines, if ever siya nga ipadala dahil nga wala na tayong delegate dahil nag-back out na nga yung si Krishna Gravides. If ever tomorrow na, just like what she said, I hope that she is really prepared dahil talagang she has the beauty, the height, but she's not confident. I think that's para siyang kinakabahan always habang nagsasalita. Alexi May Brooks, I think they need to master how she will look more feminine. She doesn't have to look soft dahil athletic talaga siya. But I think styling, makeup, everything should be more feminine. Para naman, kasi first glance talaga, iba yung tsura niya. Iba yung tingin ko sa kanya. Iba yung dating sa akin. And Tara Valencia, yun. Communication skills wise, kailangan pa niya talagang mag-aral, mag-training. And kay Ahtisa Manalo again, just be consistent. Be consistent of what she is showing now because she is ready, more than ready to compete internationally. Which, given naman na nag-compete na siya internationally back in 2018. So this is a very quick video. This is just my personal opinion, personal review assessment para sa 4 delegates ng Pilipinas, para sa kanilang mga international pageant. Thank you for watching and let me know your thought. Leave your comment down below. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.